All right, let's look at some of these matchups here. Is there any faux outrage by you with what?
No. Okay. Honestly, you know me. You know me. I'm Bitter Betty. I can usually find a bunch of stuff. Like, do I think you know Clemson and NC State are probably better than Belmont and Temple? Like, yeah. But you know what? Fran Duffy is like one of the world's greatest guys, Mr. Philadelphia. It's probably his last game, and like, why not throw a bone to Belmont and say that the net actually matters? No, this year, I swear, and part of it is we got helped out because we had some bid steals. You know, we had the Atlantic 10. You know, VCU lose and lost their best player to injury. We don't know if he'll play. We had a couple other, you know, the Mountain West, you know, also gave us, you know, kind of a crazy, screwy ending. And so we had a couple of bid steals, which ended up what was a super weak bubble became a decent bubble. Indiana's good enough to be there. You can't lose 12 out of 13 games playing the NCAA tournament. NC State, you know, they didn't beat any of the good teams in the ACC. And Clemson just had a disappointing year after surprising you last year. So I'm not really bummed for all three of those.
How many teams have what you think is a legitimate chance to win it all?
You nailed it. You're kind of on fire today,
Thank
Dan.
You. Thank
it's like
you.
Six. Right?
Yeah.
And then, you know, you throw in the, it's like spades. Like, you know, I got five of the possible or six. I mean, Carolina, Duke, Kentucky, Gonzaga, Tennessee, Virginia, although is there ever going to be a more watched 116 game than Virginia against Gardner-Webb? And by the way, Gardner-Webb is not bad and probably shouldn't be a 16 seed. Like the low seeds are kind of screwy in some of these things. But I would say, you know, that's kind of your general working list. And I called the Michigan State game on radio, and I do think that Michigan State got a little screwed, not in being the two seed where you can't put them in Duke's bracket, but more you play them on a Thursday, you know, you play them on a Thursday after playing that incredible war. I would make sure you play them on a Friday, but I don't think that Michigan State or Michigan have the horses to win it all, but it wouldn't stun me if somehow one of those teams found a way to get in there. And then, you know, there's the, I actually think Nevada is really good. I think Buffalo was underseeded. I think they're really good. I mean, you look for Cinderellas, but I think you nailed it. Probably about six teams that can win it.
Yeah. I'm looking at the Cinderella team and then you start to think it's plural. There's a lot of Cinderella teams. It feels like, and you know, somebody's getting in. It always feels like somebody sneaks into the Elite Eight. That team is going to be who?
Wouldn't stun me if it's Buffalo.
Yeah, me neither.
It just would not stun me. Now, Buffalo, the two teams that they may play, like St. John's is super, super talented with Shamari Pons. And then Arizona State, Bobby Hurley's club, they're going to play St. John's. They can beat anybody. I mean, they're just kind of erratic. They have a freshman, Lou Dort, who's a Canadian kid who's built. He's built like a linebacker. You know, he can throw in a couple of threes, and they have freak athletes on those teams. So I think Buffalo's in for a hellacious first game. But if they can get past it, like, look, Buffalo is real, absolutely real. You know, the thing that screwed this whole thing up is Duke has had a bunch of injuries. And I don't know what Syracuse's seed is or if they get in, if they don't beat Duke, and Duke was down two players and they play them. Carolina gets a one seed because they beat Duke, but Duke didn't have Zion either time. You know, it's really interesting how the Duke injuries. And then you have Duke, who we all think has a great shot to win it, but they can't shoot. I mean, we have an entire, right? Like, who wins a national championship? One with freshmen and two freshmen that cannot shoot. It's going to be, everybody has that fundamental flaw. And I don't feel icky at all. I pick Kentucky to win the whole thing.
I was all in on Kentucky a couple of weeks ago. And then all of a sudden I went, oh, man, come on. It didn't feel like they were elevating their game. Although I do give credit to John Calipari, you know, as an interior designer, when he was on yesterday when they were interviewing him and he had all of his former players' jerseys behind him, I thought it was brilliant. But, man, I was all in on Kentucky a couple of weeks ago. Not as much now.
That was a baller move. But look, they have they got one of everything. You know, you got like Tyler Hero, who's like their Rex Chapman electric score. And then you got Keldon Johnson, who just, he's kind of an elegant scorer. And then this kid Ashton Higgins, their point guard, is a lockdown defender. Can't shoot, but like, and then you have Reed Travis and PJ Washington inside. One's a, one can, you know, defend the rim, the other one's a scorer. I mean, look, I think they beat Tennessee if Reed Travis doesn't foul out. And look, I got my questions about them, but, and I would love to see a rematch of Duke. Duke ran them off the floor to start the year, but it was so long ago they kind of figured it out. So, but look, you nailed it. You got six teams, and there'll be a little bit of craziness. But I generally think we know who the cream is, and I'd be stunned if we didn't have. And I mean, hell, Gonzaga, you know, I know they lost to Carolina, and lost to Tennessee, but they beat Duke. They're going to be right there. The questions with them and Tennessee with their backcourt, but they're loaded, and they played for a national championship before. So I think we'll have a good tournament, but I'm not sure we're going to have the number of Sweet 16 or Elite Eight surprises we've had in years in the past.
For more Dan Patrick Show, tune to Audience Channel 239 on DirecTV or download the Dan Patrick Show app.